Everybody plays a part in this. Ain't no chucking. We coming from the parks where the gun sparks after dark. You got your 3-point shooters. Scrub too quick to find you out, cause your style is out. We drinking quartz on quartz, so how you handling? Shooting bricks or selling bricks? We still scrambling with offense and defense. I use the baseline to score points frequent. Yo, 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 check the mic so I can slam without a crossover. Whack, jump shot, punk rock, players get tossed over by the bleachers. I'm bringing pressure like a power forward. You try to walk and get away with it, the ref saw it. Your starting five couldn't get verbal off. I penetrate across the lane, all reads is mine. Percentage from the field is real, we hardballing. Swift shot in your face, your coach is calling for a timeout. I bomb your rhyme out with a free throw. Fast break through the legs, crush a rookie ego. You stepping out of bounds, son. Now how that sound done? I thought we was playing ball. Don't start a round one.
Time the fuck out. I got an illegal defense on the whack MC. Number 4, you can't be doing that shit. Hold on, God. Peace, God. Hold on. Hold on.
Oh, shit, I'm snuffing.
So
I know niggas liver than Allen Iverson. Take it to the hole and roll it in. Triple double win. Suicide drills, get your calves built. Crossovers ill, have you thinking water spilt? With the 2-3 zone, we smoke them like Bozo with the W-I-N. We punching home, sore losers take off their jersey. His name James Worthy. Your bench mackers, they ain't get their hands dirty. Lane, better not open up that Gatorade till you get game. Sport, hit the gym and train. Do some jumping jacks and sit-ups, then maybe you can get up. But as for now, the scoreboard gets lit up. Take it down the middle and throw it all day. We number one draft pick, WSA. Nigga, you can't stop my J. How I do it every day.
What's up, you fucking derelicts? This is Bloodstain Lane, a.k.a. the Ozone Park Bandit. Here with my partner in crime,
Mr. Fahrenheit, a.k.a. Spike Lee of YouTube.
And basically what you're about to see in this fucking video is me and Fahrenheit ventured out to the Midwest, to Columbus, Ohio, to see the Strike Force card out there that featured, you know, a few of our favorite fighters, you know, Dan Henderson, Melvin Manoff, Marlos Kunin. You know, we traveled out there, you know, and what do you have to say about what we're about to see in this video?
So this is a good time, man. We got a lot of footage backstage of the weigh-ins. We have a couple of exclusive interviews with a couple of the fighters. I think we got some good stuff in there, man.
We didn't get everything we wanted to get in this video.
Nah, we didn't.
You know, we were running around like fucking, you know what I'm saying, like maniacs.
We're living the fucking life, bro.
And, you know, but we definitely got some, you know, behind-the-scenes shit, a couple of interviews with a couple of our favorite fighters. So, yeah, enjoy this video. Like I said in the last video, you know, grab whatever you're going to grab. Your fucking Doritos, your fucking hot dogs, your beer, your vodka, your crack, your coke, whatever you guys fucking do out there.
E&J Brandy.
E&J Brandy, that's your shit right there. And also just one more thing. I see all you fucking bozos on the internet, on the forums, talking shit. The UG, Sherdog, stop talking shit, man. I'm all over the place now. I'm going out to San Diego next month, right? We're going to that Strike Force card. Now I'm in Jersey this week at the UFC. I'm all over the place. Stop talking on the forums and come get at me. You know what I'm saying? It's easy to sit behind your keyboard and talk all that shit, but I'm all over the place now. And I announced it on my Twitter where I'm gonna be. So stop fucking yapping. And one more thing I gotta say, man. There was a picture that we took with, that you took of me and Marlos Kunin.
Right, from the hotel, right?
Yeah, from the hotel, after we, you know.
I remember.
We went back to the hotel room with our boyfriend, Romer, and
great guy,
Martin DeYoung, and, you know, we celebrated great with some pizza. And we took some, you know, pictures. And basically, Marlos Kunin, you know, took a picture, you know, with a hat and shades, basically mimicking the whole Bloodstain character.
Right,
and,
right,
you know, throwing up a middle finger. And basically, it was just her mimicking Bloodstain. It had nothing to do with Misha Tate or throwing middle fingers at Misha Tate. Marlos would never do some shit like that. So mixedmartialarts.com, stop fucking posting fucking false stories, bullshit rumors, man. That shit wasn't true. You had no fucking source. Shut the fuck up with that bullshit.
It's defamation of character.
Defamation of character, absolutely.
Take that shit
and
down.
Like I said, Marlos Kunin's one of the nicest human beings we've ever came across in our life.
We say at the end of the video, yeah, we say at the beginning,
yes,
of the video. Definitely.
Absolutely. And that being said, one more thing. I just want to give a shout out to all my people in Japan who had that earthquake out there, the 8.9.
Thoughts and prayers with you guys.
Yeah, absolutely. Shout out to everybody in Japan. You know, we love Japan. And,
that we do. Love it like it was my own country.
That's it. You know what to do with your life. I ain't gonna keep on saying it. Watch the fucking video. If not, click the little Xbox in the corner. Shut the fuck up. Let's get out of here.
In the cage tomorrow night with this fight, world-class middleweight Jim Kennedy versus Melvin Manhoff. The world, Rafael Feijão versus Dan Henderson. Woo! Once again, ladies and gentlemen, the action starts tomorrow night at the Nationwide Arena, 7:30 for the first bout. We go live on Showtime at 10 p.m. $25 can get you into the door. We still have good seats available. Ticketmaster.com, the Nationwide Arena box office, also at the Strikeforce booth. A lot going on at the Strikeforce booth throughout the weekend, but you have a chance to get some good seats there tonight for our big fight card tomorrow night, brought to you by Strikeforce, Showtime, and Rockstar Energy Drink.
What's up, you fucking bozos? Buzz St. Lane here with one of my heroes and idols in the sport, somebody I really look forward to, and one of the only men on this planet that I fear. Melvin Manhoff. How's it going, Melvin?
Great, man.
Pleasure to meet you, man. I talked to him on Facebook a lot, and this is like, you know, real honor for me. Now, Melvin, one thing I gotta say, if there was one person that could have my back in a street fight, it would be you.
Yeah.
Like, all the fighters, it would be you.
I'll second that, for sure.
I have my dream is for me and you to be in a bar or in a club just peeling off a motherfucker, bro. Back to back, just knocking motherfucker the fuck out. You know, I dream about it. When I'm at work, I dream about it. You and Bada just tearing out a whole fucking club together. Other than that, though, how you feel going into this fight?
Yeah, I feel pretty good, man. I feel pretty awesome. We trained very hard, even though it was like short notice. But we trained so hard, and I think we prepared good, so it's going to be a hell of a fight, you know, and I come to win, so I'm going to take Lin home.
Do you think that he's going to try to stand with you, or what do you think?
It doesn't matter. If he tries to stand with me, I'm prepared. If he want to go to the ground, I have my takedown defense, I'm prepared also. So, you know, everything what he wants to do, I'm prepared, and I'm going to give him punishment for that. So I think it doesn't matter what he wants to do, you know. I'm gonna do my game plan, and this is the most important thing, I think.
You know what the most important thing is right here? This is probably pound for pound the most ferocious striker in all of mixed martial arts history. 23 knockouts and 24 wins. It doesn't matter. Okay, honestly, mixed martial arts is a well-rounded game, but this is Melvin No Mercy Manhoof. Ladies and gentlemen, on Saturday night, be ready for one thing. If it's not the left, it's gonna be the right. And together, it's Dutch Dynamite.
That's
hello.
Nice.
Yeah, Moro.
Yeah, baby.
So, you know, you heard it from Moro. Now, Melvin, you know, how do you feel about the possible demise? I know you fought in K1 MMA. How do you feel about K1 possibly, you know, not being around anymore? Is that something, you know?
Yeah, of course, it bothers me a little bit, but I heard, like, some great news that the K1 will come back in June.
Okay.
They're going to do something in China or something. So, you know, I will watch what's going to happen with that, you know. But for now, I still have to focus on this fight because, you know, this is very important for me, you know, this fight.
Absolutely, and, like I said, this to me, like I said in the video, I know I did a video about you. If you don't like Melvin Manhoof, you don't like fighting. This guy is the definition of a fighter. He goes in there and he tries to knock your fucking head off. He doesn't put you against a cage. He doesn't lay on you for three rounds. And that's, honestly, I think that's why, like, you know, to me, you're a hero to me. How do you feel about the current climate of just, like, the fighting in MMA? It seems like a lot of guys are just game planning and just trying to win decisions, you know?
Yes, I know. And it's very hard, you know. And I'm not that kind of guy. Yeah. And that also cost me sometimes my game, you know. It cost me a lot of loss, you know, because I take too many risks and I want to bang and I want to fuck everybody up. And this is a little bit something, but me and my trainer said I have to take a little bit of gas back, you know. But sometimes I don't listen because if somebody hit me or something, I want to go ballistic.
See, at the end of the day, Melvin, this is why people love you. This is why you have fans. Yeah. Win or lose, we know what you're getting. You know you're gonna go out there and try to just take somebody's head off. And this is why you have a loyal following and such a loyal, you know, group of supporters follow
man.
You. And you know, like, you know, everybody in my Team Takeover supports you, you know, my friend Still Will did a highlight video of you that was just an awesome highlight. Shout out to Still Will for that. And you know, we always support you. I came out here pretty much to watch you fight. You know? I took two planes, you know, I had to see you at least fight live once in my life. And like I said, man, it's a real honor to be here,
thanks,
and
also,
thank you for
the
time.
Also, awesome to be here with you. And everything is nice, your shirt is nice, so.
Yeah, and the
right
shirt
here,
is also nice.
And don't forget, he goes by the White Melvin Manhoof, bro.
I call myself the White Melvin
Manhoof. White No Mercy. Yeah, it's no problem, man. It's good.
Live for this shit. That's your quote. I live for this shit. That's my boy right here.
And this is what we're going to do tomorrow.
That's right.
We're going to live for it, man.
And if any of you fucking bozos talk bad about my boy Melvin, I'm going to knock your fucking head off. Don't talk shit about my boy.
You see?
All right?
My brother
that's
from
it.
Out of money,
that's
man.
It, baby. The White Melvin Manhoof right here.
Thank you.
All right? Yeah. Good luck tomorrow, brother. I'll be here for you, all right, man?
Peace out. Yes.
Have a good one, man.
See you later, guys. Bye.
Later, Melvin. What's up, bozos? Bloodstained Lane here with my favorite trainer, Mike Pazinier of the legendary Mike Gym. Mike, how's it going, brother?
I'm okay, you?
Doing very good. You know, it's a pleasure meeting you for the first time, you know, and Mike, how do you feel about Melvin? How was his training camp going into this fight?
Oh, we're doing actually pretty good. I think we changed it a little bit, but not that much. You know, so tomorrow you don't see a different Melvin.
Well, you know what? Melvin's Melvin. That's what he does. He goes out there and tries to hurt you. And that's why Mike's gym, I love Mike's gym. I like guys that go out there. That's why I love Bada, you know, Murphy and Melvin. Because you guys seem like in your gym, you have that style that just go out there and be aggressive and kill people. Is that your philosophy? What's the Mike's gym philosophy?
Well, the philosophy is, it's like if you want to please the audience, first of all, you know, if you, for instance, you have a job. You know, you make something like $1,200 a month or $1,500. No, you go to a game with your sons or your kids or your wife. You pay a lot of money to see some great athletes. You know? And then all of a sudden these guys are only touching gloves, you know, nodding at each other. Yeah. I don't think that's possible. That's a good thing, you know. So in my philosophy, I think, listen, kill or be killed.
That's,
you know,
it.
There's only one winner, and then you don't have to leave it up to the judges. But sometimes, you know, we're not in the position to kill the other one or to knock the other one out. So, no.
But you know what? But at least that's the mind state going. To me, the whole point of being in a fight is to knock the guy out, make sure the fight is finished, you know, not to go to the judge. And, you know, that's why, you know, me, I'm always, you know, a huge supporter of Mike's gym. You know, Melvin Manoff and Bada Harry are two of my heroes in this sport. And speaking of Bada, you know, Bada's been away for a while. How is he, you know, how's he looking right now? Is he starting to get back into shape? Is, you know...
Well, actually, he's already in shape.
Okay.
And when Hasty was in a little bit in trouble, but they picked him up for nothing.
Yeah.
And then they asked Bada if he can replace it, and he said, yes, I want to, but I want to have Mike in my corner. Then that's not possible because I have to be here today, and then I cannot be here tomorrow in Amsterdam. So he was already in a good way in shape, you know. Last time he did a good television interview, a good response of that. And he's training every day hard.
Do you think Bada's the most talented guy you've ever coached?
Yeah. Well, yes. I think, but talent goes a long way, you know, and it's a very wide understanding.
Absolutely.
You know, some guys have talent to like Bada. You know, he's feeling a fight.
Yes.
You know, other guys like Melvin. He has a talent to strike hard. Everything he does is explosive.
Yes.
That's enough talent. The other guys, they just work hard.
They
work hard every day, like Yurimes. He works for, I think, 70 years.
Yes.
Every day, really, really hard. He's got lungs like he's a horse, you know, and he can give punching combinations. He doesn't come with 1-2, no, he comes with like 12 to 15 punches and kicking, and then he just takes one zip of air and then go at it again. You know, they got guys like Myrtle, he's very talented, very athletic, but he needs to learn a little bit more and he needs to have some patience. So there's all kinds of talents, you know, sometimes it's hard work, sometimes just...
And Yurimes, and just for you guys that don't know, Yurimes is the logo of Mike's gym. He's the silhouette of Mike's gym.
Yes.
And I suggest a lot of you people who don't know about Yurimes to go on YouTube some of it. This guy was one of the best combination strikers I've ever seen.
Yes.
In terms of putting the punches and kicks together. I mean, he was a real special fighter, you know.
Yes.
And
for me too, he was my first fighter, and like we like to say, you know, we made each other famous.
Yes.
Because nobody knows about me, then he said, oh, who's that bald white guy?
Yeah.
You know, kicking everybody's ass, knocking everybody out in round 3-4, or sometimes in the first round. And then the guys got to train with me, said, listen, Mike, maybe you can help us. Like Dick Fry, Hans Nama, Joop Castells, the Tornhauser, Peter Verschuren. You know, they used to come train with me, so that build up my name. And at the end, and then Melvin was coming, then Bada was coming, you know, then my name was established, and then My new fighters are coming, like Murto, and I've got also a few talented young fighters like Mikey the Dunn, Clay Bobeldijk, Timo van Santen, Melanie Geugers, Massaro Glunder.
So these are some names this, we should be looking out for right now.
Yes, but I just tell that they're between 16 and I think the oldest is 18. But if you see them, they're really gifted, you know, good footwork, hard punches, also always go for the knockout, even how small they are, you know, and well, sometimes it's, I don't want to say embarrassing, but, you know, there's a guy coming from another gym, or coming from another country, and he said, okay, I'll go with the small guy, and the small guy just kick his ass, it's a whole different type of mentality. These guys that just want to train hard, that just want to kick hard, that just want to punch hard, and then fight. Well, if it's up to them every week, but then at the end of the day, they fight, so they go home. Well, I can see you Monday. And most of them, you know, in the old days, they said, oh, I just fought, I just take 2-3 weeks off. No, they said, well, I can see you Monday. Or, oh, I have a little bit of pain in my chin, I see you Tuesday.
Absolutely. And Mike, you did a YouTube video for me a little bit while ago. You invited me to come down. You said, yeah, I got your back.
Yes.
So, you know, I definitely plan on coming to visit you guys one day. And I want to train with you guys. It'd be a dream of mine. You know, I really look up to you and all your fighters there. I mean, I watch. My brother could tell you I'm like the biggest Mike Gym fan in the United States, you know. And I'm going to take your partner now offer and come visit you one day.
No problem. You can come. You know, and you can. You can lift the 1 week, 2 weeks. I don't know how long do you want to stay. You know, you can submit to the training, to the workout, to the dedication. You know, to the brotherhood.
That's what I want to do.
Yes, because that's you know, one of my mottos: be all you can be. Some guys, they are not very good fighters, but you know they can bring out the best of them at the moment, and that. That could be one fight in a show somewhere, or it could be in the finals of Tokyo.
Absolutely.
And as long as everybody knows it and feels like this and live up to that, you know, then you get the best out of people. If you get the best out of people, how can it go wrong?
I agree. And I just want to say shout out to Danny Delvis, you know, from the gym. Danny's a good guy. Came to Holland, had a great time.
He's a big help for me too in the gym.
He's a great guy, you know. Him and my brother did some funny shit in a club. They took a bottle of vodka from somebody.
They stole a bottle.
Yeah, man.
Danny, stop corrupting my brother, bro. You're corrupting my brother. You might be corrupting Danny. But that being said, Mike, just one last question. You know, you're very known for when the entrance comes in, you get in, your fighters fit, and you get them riled up. What is going on when you talk to them? Like, what are you telling them?
Oh, well,
just
listen,
hyping them up?
I don't know. Just, I say some things, you know, and then I just want to push them that extra little bit, you know, push them some more so they're really, to get them pumped up and even more than pumped up, and then, you know, and then it's time to go, you know, it's like unleashing them and then they go and they, you know.
I tell you the truth, I wish I could borrow you so you can do that when I go to work every morning. You get me motivated to go, I don't want to go to work anymore, man. So maybe if you actually came into my room and started yelling at me, I'd want to go to work in the morning. That being said, Mike, it was an honor hanging out with you. Pleasure. I'm going to come out and visit you one day, and I'm going to be there tomorrow, you know, showing you support, and like I said.
We're going to put up another big show, you know, and another exciting show. And
what do you think? What's your prediction?
What is the prediction? I think we're going to win by knockout.
Mike.
We're like Barcelona.
That's it. Busse Lane, Mike Passanier, Mike's Gym, Melvin Manoff, knockout tomorrow. You heard it here first.
Boos.
Boos. Mike, I'll talk to you later, man. What's up, you fucking bozos? It's Busse Lane, a.k.a. the American Martin DeYoung. And I'm here with... Martin, first of all, before we discuss anything, what do you think about this? Me, personally, I think Columbus, Ohio is a real shitty city. How do you feel about this place?
It's not one of my favorite cities in America, man. I mean, you know, it's
quite boring, bro.
It's quite boring, I have to say, man. I mean, I like the West Coast better, though. I know you're from New York, but New Jersey was good either, though. But, I mean, you know,
It is what
we're,
it is.
We're here.
You're here for business. You're here for business. All right.
I wouldn't book my vacation here.
No, listen to me. I'm never coming back here again. The women here are not that, you know, hot. The food sucks. Whatever. You know what? Let's not talk about that. Let's get right down to the fucking nitty gritty here. I seen, you know, going on Twitter, you know. What's going on with Misha Tate, bro?
I don't know, man. She pulled out like 10 days before the fight. I mean, if somebody has an injury that's real serious, and I feel really bad for fighters when they have a real injury and pull out. But you know what? The thing that bothered me is that she knew that she wasn't going to fight on Sunday, and after Wednesday, she was still promoting her fight with Marloes. And then doing all this stuff on Twitter, like if I get like 5,000 followers before my fight with Marloes, I'm going to give away free t-shirts and stuff. You know what? She was even on a radio show promoting the fight on Wednesday, like an hour before Showtime was going to announce that that she was going to pull out.
Yeah.
I mean, what kind of shit is that, man? I feel it's kind of disrespectful to Marloes and to Strikeforce, and you know, I was like, okay, I can understand she has an injury, but then she's like a couple days later, she's tweeting that she's back in training again and will be good in a few weeks. I was like, you know, you're a fighter.
Yeah,
that injuries happen, and shoot woman up and just suck it up and go.
Well, it seems like a lot of people agree with you guys. I've been seeing a lot of people on Twitter saying the same thing, that she backed out. Do you think maybe she was scared or she wasn't prepared for Marloes? You know, because Marloes is she's a whole different animal. She is, in my opinion, you know, the top three female fighters in the world are, you know, Cyborg, Marloes, and Megumi Fuji. Those are my personal top three. Do you think Misha maybe was nervous? What do you think was her logic behind doing this?
You know, I have no idea though, but I don't have an idea, but I just think it's kind of strange, and I think that...
You just want to leave it at that? Like, you
know,
I
don't know. Yeah. You know what? I mean, I asked for doctor's papers. I didn't get it. A doctor report on it.
Really?
No, I didn't get it.
Wow.
I asked for it.
Okay,
I mean, you know, if you pull out like 10 days before a fight and we prepared for a certain fight for 6 weeks, I want to see a doctor report. That's not crazy,
and
is it?
And that never came up.
So
that's some shady shit.
I'm not saying she's dogging it. I don't say she doesn't have an injury, but still, I mean, it's the thing that struck me most is that she kept promoting after she knew that she was not going to fight. And
we're not saying she's a bad fighter either. You're not saying she's a good fighter.
I mean, I appreciate her as a fighter, but the way she handled this, I don't think was good.
And I appreciate her as just a sexy woman with a nice behind. And Mauro's gonna come back in our video. Keep coming in.
Who's my boy here?
Keep coming in. Bloodstained Lane right here.
Bloodstained Lane. You know, on Twitter, I saw my Bloodstained Lane right here.
Listen,
does he like me or does he not?
No. I never said anything bad about you.
You like me? Because I read Bloodstained.
No.
Yeah, man.
He gets similar.
I never said a bad thing about him.
No, it doesn't matter if you did it or not. But I know he's controversial. He's provocative.
He always
brings the joy and never the pain.
That's it.
He's Bloodstained Lane.
You heard it.
Now,
yet.
This guy right here, he may be playing a song in a different key. He comes from Amsterdam, Utrecht. And look at me. I like it when it's 420 all the time. I may be Canadian, but I can still compose a rhyme. So at the end of the day, when all is said and done, Bloodstained Lane, Martin de Jong, Marloes Koenen. You know I'm the one.
That's Marinello. Marloes Koenen wiped him out in Amsterdam.
Yo.
She took him down in a restaurant, man. That's where to go.
Mauro's had a few to drink, man.
You think so?
Oh, absolutely, man. So listen, he's hamming right now. He's hamming.
Oh yeah.
We're gonna get him back in here.
We just got a new nickname for Marloes Koenen. It's the Golden Girl of Golden Glory.
Oh shit.
Marloes Koenen.
Okay, Harry comes back.
What do you think about Marloes' new nickname? The Golden Girl.
Oh,
Team Golden
yes.
Glory.
Yes. No, let's start this up right now.
Let's talk a little bit
Rumina,
about that.
Yeah, you're right. The nickname Rumina, obviously. Rumina Sato, obviously. Flying Armbar, love you. Female Hicks and Gracie, obviously. Marloes Koenen is the one. Golden Girl of Golden Glory. She is the Golden Girl. And it doesn't matter what female you are, man you are, she's guaranteed to rock your world. Just remember this. Rue McClanahan, B. Arthur, and who's the other one? Estelle Getty's already dead. Betty White's the Golden Girl right now. I'd rather watch Marloes Koenen instead.
Oh my god.
There he goes.
He's done. Marijuana. Somebody pack it in for the night for him.
Marijuana.
Let's go. Okay, now she was.
Wow. He fucked up the whole field.
Nah, but you know what? We're gonna keep it. This is the way we do shit. We're not gonna edit this shit. This is it. This is real life shit.
Mauro's
right here.
Friend, though. He's always commentating at the United Glory, man.
He's hamming right now. So, Mauro, when you see this video, we ain't editing this shit, brother. But thanks for showing up. So, now listen. Misha is, you know, out. What do you think about this new opponent, Mauro's?
I mean, I respect Liz a lot. She stepped up on a 10-day notice. I really appreciate that, and I think she's a tough girl. Yeah, let's see what happens. I mean, I think her stand-up is even better than Misha's, and all-round game is good. So let's see what happens. I mean, I really respect her for stepping up at the last moment.
How do you see this fight going down? You know, I know you. You know,
I don't see it going five rounds.
I don't see it. I tell you the truth. Listen, I don't see it going past two at the most. I know. Listen, you know, obviously you got to go. You train her, so you're gonna be biased. But you know, Marlus is my favorite female fighter. I just don't think. She doesn't match up to the skill level. I mean, you're talking about Marlus is world fucking class, bro.
She's been in this game for 11 years.
11 years, and she is, to me, the perfect spokesperson for female MMA. I don't think you can get a better role model for female MMA than Marlus. Would you agree with me on that one?
I appreciate it.
Like I said, you know, going off the fight now, you know what I'm saying? We have that big fight tomorrow. I know you have a big event coming up. You want to plug that and talk about it right now?
Yeah, on March 19th, we have a Glory event, the Glory World Series, second round, in Charleroi, Belgium. You say that, Charleroi.
Charleroi. I don't fucking know, bro.
Charleroi, Belgium.
Whatever, I don't fucking know. But you got a great event, talk about it, man.
We got like the semifinals, two $150,000 tournaments, like kickboxing, Gökhan Saki, Brice Guidon, Murat Buzidi, and...
Don't forget my boy. See y'all the killer, bro.
No, that's the kickboxing tournament, man.
Okay. Oh, you talking about the kickboxing tournament?
Yeah, that's Vendor Rocher, and then there's a MMA tournament, $150,000 as well. That's See y'all the killer, John Alessio, Tommy the Bread, and Rohan Chicago Canelo. So that's going to be fun. Nicky Holsk is going to be fighting there. Errol Zimmerman is going to be fighting there. It's going to be a huge show. March 19th, Charleroi, Belgium, united-glory.com. Everybody, it's going to be on HDNet, so.
It's going to be on HDNet, and yo, first of all, that's one more thing. Motherfucker, stop hating on my boy CR the Killer. All you organizations out there, get my boy a fucking fight, all right? My boy's a beast, you know what I'm saying? Stop hating on him, you know, strike force. Step to the fucking plate and get my boy CR a fight, right? Stop with the bullshit already, you know what I'm saying? That being said, Bloodstain, Martin DeYoung, Martin, what do you guys say to these fucking bozos?
Fuck your life, you fucking bozos.
Respect the shooter. We're going out to drink now, motherfucker. Yeah, get the fucking shit out of my face. Bloodstain Lane, a.k.a. Melvin Manoff dancing on you motherfuckers. And today is the day, you know, we're in Columbus, Ohio for the Strikeforce card. We're here to support, you know, three fighters that we really like, that, you know, we're huge fans of. Melvin Manoff, you see the Melvin Manoff tracksuit I got on, the Melvin Manoff Scully. Also, my girl over here, Marlos Kunin, hooked us up with the free Marlos Kunin swag yesterday from Moore State. You know what I'm saying? Marlos, thanks again, Marlos. Thanks for the Dutch chocolate also. Anybody talk shit about Marlos Kunin has a fucking problem with me and Team Takeover.
It's on and popping, son.
On and popping. One of the nicest people you ever meet. And also, my Captain America, Dan Hendo Henderson. We're hoping for, you know, three wins today. You know, we're going to be there supporting. Shout out to everybody at Strikeforce that treated us good this week. Shannon Knapp. And yeah, about to get this shit popping, son.
We hitting up another strip club tonight or what?
Nah, man. These bitches ain't getting my money. And just one thing I gotta say is...
You got took, son.
I got took. I got took hard. But that's never happening again. Strikeforce, please don't... no disrespect to Columbus. City's not fucking cracking, son. It ain't cracking. You know what
I mean? This shit ain't on and popping, son.
This shit ain't on and popping, bro. You know what I'm saying? Queens get the money. Fuck your life.
No doubt in D.
Respect the shooter. Bang.
Yeah, where we going, bro?
I want to get some fucking grub. I just want you to take a fucking look at this shitty ass city, you know what I'm saying? You know, if you're from Ohio, props to all my Ohio supporters. Your city's not, you know what I'm saying? It's boring, man. It's just dead out here. There's no women.
Let's go down here.
There's probably some homos waiting for us to grab us, dude. I ain't fucking going on, man. Listen, man. Where the women at? What the fuck's going on over here, bro? You know what I'm saying? This makes my fucking neighborhood look like Las Vegas. It makes going to the corner store for the turkey sandwich like going to the Borgata, bro. You know what I'm saying? Dude, it's whack, bro. That being said, we're gonna get something to eat now. And that's it, man. You know what I'm saying? I just see Mike Passanier walking the streets. We just talked about the strategy for the fight. And that's it, man. Put that fucking camera, man. I'm getting tired of this shit in my face all day, bro. Real talk.
What's up, you fucking peasants? Bloodstain Lane, here eating fucking some lobster mac and cheese. My pre-fight meal. What do you motherfuckers know about this, man? Huh? Eating good food. 5-star restaurants. Living life, man. Living the American dream right here, man. Same. Fahrenheit. What'd you order, kid?
Some sort of salad.
Stop eating that pussy shit, man. Fucking salad, man.
Bro, I wanna eat light, bro.
When you hang out with me, I don't want no salads, you know what I'm saying? Just eat some fucking lobster, kid. Real G shit right here. Hezzy Gurgis shit, son. We're getting that Hezzy Gurgis money over here, B. You know what I'm saying? Queens get the money all day. Wore Melvin Manoff. Wore Marlos Cooney. Wore Dan Henderson. After the fights, we'll be popping models, Rampage Jackson. All you trolls on the forums, what's your life like? You know what I'm saying? Stop playing video games, motherfucker. We'll get some tail, man. I'll let you boy. Spit camera off.
So what do you think of the car, bro?
That's not the time for this. Give me a fucking couple seconds, Jerkoff.
Sorry.
Fucking dickwad. Just make sure you have my fucking money, alright? You've been fucking ducking me for how long already, you fucking jerk off? You have 2 days to have my fucking money. Otherwise, you're gonna have a fucking problem. Let me know right now, you fucking Just have my shit, cocksucker. Fucking jerk off. What's up, you fucking peasants?
Who's that?
It's my fucking agent. He fucking owes me fucking money he hasn't gave me yet. I'm gonna fucking slap the shit out of him pretty soon. Basically, you know, the Strikeforce card, we just did it, you know, up in Columbus, Ohio. Pretty solid card. It was, you know, we were here for a few, you know, quite a few fighters that we supported. Melvin Manoff, Marlos Coonan, and Dan Henderson. We're going to run down, the card real quick. The first fight you had, Jorge Masvidal making his Strikeforce debut against Billy Evangelista. Not really an exciting fight. You know, Masvidal's a guy who's really known for always bringing it. This time a little bit more conservative, but you know what? I'm a huge fan of Masvidal. I'm glad he got the win. Good way to start his career off in Strikeforce. So, you know, we plan to save this fight, but maybe next time we'll see more, you know, the prototype Masvidal. Next fight of the night, you know, guy that we came here for, you know, from Holland, had a Mike's gym, one of my favorite gyms, Melvin Manoff fighting Tim Kennedy. And what can I say, man? I mean, like I said, I love Melvin. I'll always be a fan of the dude. And he leg kicked Tim Kennedy, almost fucking chopped him down like a fucking tree. Once Kennedy felt that, he went for a takedown. Melvin sprawled on a couple of takedowns, looked pretty good, and then Kennedy finally got the takedown and a little bit of grappling, and eventually got the rear naked choke. You know, don't know where Melvin goes from here. I mean, like I said, no matter where Melvin goes, I'm going to support the guy and be a fan of whether it's, you know, the K1 realm or MMA realm or it's Showtime. Wherever he goes, you know, Melvin's I'm always going to be a fan of. Shout out to Melvin Manoff. Next fight of the night was, you know, our girl Marlos Cooney.
Show the shirt.
Yep, the shirt that she gave me. I got the hat in the car. You know, we hung out with Marlos all weekend, man. We in a hotel room watching TV, you know, eating pizza, fucking going to restaurants. We really, you know, this was, you know, Marlos Cooney, one of the nicest people you'll ever meet. Like I said earlier, and
I'll second that, definitely.
And you know, so you know, we cheered her on. She fought Liz. What's her name?
Carmucci.
Liz Carmucci. And I'm not gonna lie to you. I gave Liz Carmucci no fucking shot in this fight. And I thought, you know, Marlos is a world class mixed martial artist. And you know what? Liz Carmucci gave her a run for her fucking money, man.
Say that name one more time.
It's Kamuchi.
I hope that's it, because if not, we're going to get tools.
I don't fucking know. Whatever it is, you know what I'm saying? Good fighter.
Tough chick.
Tough chick. And you know what, man? She had was... Man, this rounds two and three could have been... They were probably 10-8 rounds, man. And the fights were close to being stopped. You know, I was in my seat panicking, man. Because, you know...
Marlo showed insane heart in that fight, man.
Insane heart.
Heart of a champion.
And I consider Marlo's family now after, you know, all the time we spent together and all, you know... And her boyfriend, great dude, and you know, the whole team. And,
Bro, what's your favorite color, bro?
It'll be a fight. It's an inside joke. Shut the fuck up with that shit, man.
Sorry.
And, that, you know, Marlo's Kunin showed the heart of a fucking champion and one of the greatest comebacks in MMA history.
And possibly the greatest in female MMA history, I would say.
Possibly the greatest and probably top five all time. I would say so. I mean, she secured the triangle choke and got the win in round four, man. After she came close to the brink of losing twice, man. So, Marlo's Kunin, man, what can I say about this girl, man? I am such a fan of her. I'm such a fan of her as a person, as a fighter. She's just the ultimate, man. She really is. She's and if you don't support Marlo's Kunin, there's something seriously wrong with you. Because she represents what mixed martial arts is all about. You know? And, you know, going into the main event, we had the guy who I've been saying for the last few years now, my personal Captain America, my opinion, the greatest American mixed martial artist of all time, Dan Henderson, a.k.a. Hendo, versus Rafael Fajal, Team Black House. Rafael Fajal was the champion. And Dan Henderson, man. If there's three guys in MMA I don't want to fight, one of them is Dan Henderson. You know what's great about Dan Henderson? Every time he fights, you know he's coming. He has that right hand right here, just waiting to get fucking launched at all times. There's nothing you can do about it. It's like a fucking sledgehammer swinging at you. And he's so strong, and I really like him at 205. I think 205 is where he should be fighting. And,
I think the weight cut affected him.
Too much. And you can see he felt so much comfortable. He fights a lot more comfortably at 205.
Definitely.
And, he abused Rafael Fajal. And Rafael Fajal is a great fucking fighter, man. He's a great fighter. And, Dan Henderson kept launching that right hand, pushing him in the cage, bullying him against the cage, taking him down. And in the third round, he finally clipped him with that right hand and started pounding him out. And Dan Henderson, new Strikeforce 205 champion. And the guy's 40 years old, and he's still winning fucking world titles in world-class organizations. Dan Henderson got to be a top five mixed martial artist of all time, my opinion. And overall, great, fun card, great card. Thanks to everybody at Strikeforce for showing us a good time, namely Shannon Knapp. Shannon, you know what I'm saying, whatever you need, I got you. Columbus, Ohio, not my favorite city in the world, but I'm not going to hate on you guys. I'm going to give you guys a lot of hate in this video. It is what it is. And that's it. Blessing Lane, you got anything to say, Fahrenheit?
We got a flight to catch in about an hour. We got to go.
We got to get to New York City.
Get the fuck out of here, bro.
You know what I'm saying? Queens get the money. You know what I'm saying?
All day, son.
Yeah, motherfucker.
Fuck your life, you fucking bozos.